So, last class, we have started the lesson of magnetic effect of a electric current, and I have completed about the magnetic field and field lines and magnetic field due to the current carrying conductor, right? And a right hand thumb rule also. So, today we'll start and even magnetic field due to current through circular loop, okay? And a solenoid, right? Yeah. These are the points I have completed in the last class. So, today we'll go for next. That is, okay, that is force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. Force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. Okay, so what we learned in the rule of a right hand thumb rule, what you learned here? This is our right hand, right? And if it is the direction of a current, then this is the direction of a magnetic effects, right? This is the radiation of a magnetic lines here. So here, one more thing it is adding here. When where is the direction of a force here? Where is the direction of a force here? Before we go for further things, before we drive for this, let us understand what we learned, the main important points in the last class. First one is, when the current is passing in a conductor, it creates a magnetic field. Yes or no? Yes or no, children? When current is going in any wire, magnetic field creates. When a current is passing in any conductor, that creates a magnetic field. Okay? So, the second point is, magnetic field depends on the current. It means here, if more current, then more magnetic field you can see. If it is a less current, then less magnetic field. Clear? So, the next point is, third point what here? Magnetic field line direction changes according to the current direction. The current direction is changes, magnetic field lines also changes, clockwise and anti-clockwise. Have you done all these points? So you have to keep all these points in your mind till we complete the portion, till we complete this lesson here. First one, when you pass any current in conductor, that creates a magnetic field. Second point here, magnetic field strength is equal to, magnetic field strength is equal to current strength. It means here, magnetic field strength depends on the current strength. More current, more strength, less current, less magnetic field strength. Third point is here, the direction of the magnetic field lines depends on the direction of the current. If the direction of a current is changing in a circuit, then the direction of a magnetic field lines also, direction of also changes, right? So these are the three important points here. Yeah. Next one is here. When you take any two magnets, they have some interaction in between. Yes or no? They have some interaction in between. This is also one magnet. This is also one magnet. Last class I have explained about this. So when you take these two magnets, they might have a attract or repel. They might have attract or repel. This is the interaction these two magnets are having in between them. Yes. So here, at what time they attract, at what time they repel? It depends on the poles. It depends on the poles here, right? It depends on the electromagnetic force. Why they do that one? Because of the electromagnetic force. What I'm saying here, before we go for this, force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. What I'm giving you is one simple example. You have taken two magnets here. Okay. They are having some interaction in between them. It might be a repulsion or it might be an attraction. Why they are having? Because magnetic field has some force in between. Magnetic field has some force. Okay. You will feel the force in your hand when you are holding a magnet. Isn't it? If it is moving also, that should come in a magnetic field. That the magnetic field has a boundary. That should be in the magnetic boundary there. Clear? So they might be having a repulsion or a attraction. Yes. So when they repel and when they attract, it depends on the poles. If they are having opposite poles, then they are attract. If they are having the same poles, then they are repel. Understood this much? These simple points, you have to keep it in your mind before we go for this one. Clear? So next comes here, in your textbook, you have a diagram. Okay. in your textbook you have a diagram. Let me draw that roughly. Okay, everyone, children, you can see in your textbook. Okay, I'm just giving a one rough diagram. Sorry. So this is the strand, very simple circuit diagram it is given. Here we are having one magnet and one rod here. So what happens when you are having a magnet surround in a circuit? Okay, let us see. Here this is a strand. Here one support they are given for the wire, and our diagram, our circuit diagram will be like this. Yes, here it is a key. Here this is the battery. Okay, this how it comes till here, and yeah, this is connected to some rod here. Okay, yeah, you can see in your textbook, guys. So what were they doing here? They have kept some magnet in it. They have kept some. This is the south pole and this is the north pole. And see, make sure that whenever you have a, if you are going to draw the circuit diagram, you have to show the direction of a current when you have a positive sign of the battery. It means here you have a positive and here you have a negative. While explaining about the electricity, I have explained, no, this is the negative and this is the positive, right? So if it is positive, this side means the current is flowing in this direction. Got it, guys? The current is flowing in this direction. This is how you have a diagram. I just drawn very roughly, guys. Just check it in your textbook. Okay? Yeah. Let us see what happens here. Okay. Now, tell me, guys, when you on the circuit, it means here, when you allow some current to pass through the circuit, what happens here? Can you anyone guess and tell me? When you on the current here, what happens when current going in a circuit which is kept in middle one magnet here? Okay, so let us see. When you allow some current into the circuit, the current is flowing in this direction, what I shown here, in this direction, it come till here. Okay, and the wire is like this. Right? Yeah. And it comes to here and it is going through the rod, right? It's going through the rod till it will come here, and again it is coming back to the battery. This is the direction of a current, it is flowing here. Yes or no? This is our small experiment here. What you are doing? Here you are allowing some current into this. It is going in this direction. Here it comes. Here one rod is there. That naming as A and B. And when it comes here, it is coming to the this point. And again, it is coming back to the battery here. What happens here? Once it comes here, this current, this rod is having a current here. What was my first statement? The first statement is, if current is going in any wire magnet field, if current is going in any wire or this one magnet, it creates a magnetic field. It creates a magnetic field here. Yes or no? So if it creates a magnetic field, means it become magnet here. It is also become magnet here. Yes or no? It is also become magnet here. When this is also magnet here, this is also magnet here, according to their poles here, they might attract or they might repel. They might attract or they might repel. Understood, guys, this one? One more time, I am repeating this one. This is our circuit here. Okay. How you done here? Batteries are there. Key are there. Current is flowing in this direction. This is connected one rod in between the wire here. And one more wire I am taken from here. And it completes circuits. And then it comes to the battery here. Okay. In between, one more magnet it is kept here. Okay, so what happens when you allow some current into this wire, it is going through this conductor and it is coming back to the battery. When it comes back to the battery, it is going to start move here. It creates some magnetic field in it. It becomes also one more magnet here. Okay, so if it is one more magnet, then this is also already one more magnet is there. So those two will become, it may attract or it may repel. Okay, it might come near to the magnet or it might go away from the magnet. Understood? So here, what is our conclusion here? What is our conclusion here? It is written in the on the board here. Let us see. So when current passes through the conductor, it creates a magnetic field. When current passes through the conductor, it creates a magnetic field. Current is passing through the conductor, which is kept here. Okay. It creates a magnetic field. Okay. Next, it becomes another magnet. And that electromagnet comes in contact with other magnet. And this electromagnet comes with contact with the another magnet. It might repel or it might attract each other. Understood this much? Yes, guys? Yeah. This is our conclusion. Just take a screenshot and you can write it in the book. Okay. So today we are going to complete... what are the points here? And force current carrying on a conductor in a magnetic field and one more, Fleming's left hand rule and electric motor and electromagnetic induction. I will try to complete them. Clear? So, this is our conclusion here. Okay? Yeah. Now, we know that one, what will be the direction of a current and what will be the direction of a magnetic field lines before this by using right-hand thumb rule. Yes or no? By using right-hand thumb rule, we got to know that one, what is the direction of a current and what is the direction of a magnetic field lines here. Here one more word is added, that is force. And how the force direction will be here? What will be the force direction here? So, for that, one theoretical, theoretically how to find this one? By using that Fleming's left hand rule. I'm purposely I'm saying right hand, left hand. Here now you have to use the left hand. Okay, don't hold your right hand, guys. This is our left hand, right? Fleming's left hand rule here. Clear? Okay. So in this Fleming's left hand rule, what you need to understand here? Yeah, from that time I'm saying the one about the force current carrying conductor in a magnetic field, guys. So if you are taken it as applicable example, what example you can give here? You can give a best example is our fan, right? Fan. Okay. So we'll see that one in the next one. It comes to the about the motor electric. Okay, electric motor. Yeah. So Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, so children will get some confused of holding the fingers here while you are writing this one. Because if you hold like this one properly, then you can say the direction of a force or direction of a magnetic field lines or direction of a current in the circuit also. Any experiment also. Clear? So here, first you have to open your thumb. Okay, then this one, like this. It means here you are showing someone. Okay, or else you can think that it is a gun. Yeah, gun, yeah. And next, what you need to do, you just open your middle finger. This is how the direction of a current, force and a magnetic field. Okay, what are those? I mean, what finger indicates what direction? We'll tell you now. Have you understood how to do this one? First, a thumb rule, you have to open your thumb rule like this. Take your left hand, thumb rule, thumb and next. This one finger, index finger. Yeah. Next, this middle finger. Don't get confused. This like this, like this, like this, like this, or like this. Yeah. Like this. You can think that one gun, right? And you just open this one. Make sure that all the directions are in a 90 degree. See. All the directions are in like a 90 degree. This one. Okay, this one. Clear? Yeah. This is how you can show the direction of a magnetic field lines, current and a force. Now, this thumb rule represents a magnetic field lines. This thumb direction is force direction. What is this? This thumb direction is a force direction. And this finger, what finger it is? Index finger. This index finger shows the magnetic field lines direction. This index finger shows the magnetic field line direction. And this shows the current direction. This shows the current direction. Understood? This is the force direction. Okay. This is the magnetic field line direction. And this is the current direction. Fleming's left hand rule. This is Fleming's left hand rule. Okay. Let me show you that one by using some magnets here. Magnetic bar I am taking here. Okay. To remember this one, guys, what are the direction, or which finger is the which direction, to remember that one, I will give you some very easy method. That is, think that this is the force, right? This is the force. This is the magnetic field lines and this is the current. This is the force. This is the direction of a magnetic field and this is the current direction. Okay. Force. What is first letter? F. Magnetic field. What is first letter? M. Next. Current. What is first letter? C. So, we just keep it in mind for the mother and a child. Father means F, mother means M, child means C. Yes, father means F, mother means M, child is C. First father, next comes mother, next comes child. That's it. Don't get confused. Father, mother, child. Father, F, force, direction of a force. Mother, M, magnetic field, direction of a magnetic field. Child, C, current direction. Very simple. This is how you can keep it in your mind. Don't get confused. This children have a tendency to do the mistake here. They will say this one correct. They will say this one correct, force. Okay. In these two, they get a confused whether this is the magnetic field or this is the current or this is the current or this is the magnetic field like that. So don't get confused. What you need to do whenever you are trying this one, in the exam, if they are given the diagram and they will ask you to the direction of a magnetic field or a current or a force, what you need to do here? At that time, you have to use the Fleming's left hand rule. How you will use that one? First, you take your left hand, open this thumb and next, this finger, index finger and next, middle finger. Okay. This shows the direction of a force. This shows the direction of a magnetic field and this shows the direction of a current here. Now, father, mother, child. And make sure that all are in the 90 degree. All are in the 90 degree angle. Okay. So, this is the father and this is the mother and this is the child. Father, mother, child. Father, first word, first letter, F, force. Mother, first letter, M, magnetic field. Current, a child, first letter, C, that is current. This is how you can keep it in your mind. Okay, it's just a trick. Tricks you can use, yeah. Now, so here, I will tell you how to apply that Fleming's left hand rule in the experiments. Okay, how we will do that one? Let us see. Yeah. Here, this is the north and this is the south here. Okay. I have kept one conductor in between them. I have kept one conductor in between them here. Okay. Now, yeah. See, conductor means that when you do any circuit, you will get to know that one. What is the direction of a current here? Obviously, because you are only arranging them. Yes or no? You are only arranging them. How the what in what the direction current is going? So here, what I am doing? This is the direction of current here. This is the direction of a current. We understood. This is the direction of a current. And here, these two magnets are means a magnetic field lines direction will be like this only, no? North to south. We all learned in the first class. All the magnetic field lines shows that one represent themselves that they are coming from the north to south. In the magnetic bar, they are going from south to north. Yes. So in this direction, so you can say that one the direction, I mean the direction of a magnetic field lines is going from here. Already it is mentioned here, north and south. So they are going like this, isn't it? So we already got it two directions here. We just need to find out what is the direction of a force here. Already got two directions here. Just you need to find the what is the direction of a force here. Okay. Let us use here the thumb rule. Let us use here the thumb rule. This is our finger, thumb, Fleming's left hand rule. Like, yeah. Now, what is this? This is magnetic field line. Like this. Isn't it? And what is this? This is the current direction is like this. So it is showing. This is the current direction. You can fold like this or like this. It is comes in bit, I mean, inside the, I mean, board only, right? Yeah. This is the direction of a magnetic field. Okay. This is the direction of our current. It will not come out of the board, no? Obviously, the finger is like this, it is going down. No, I can't bend my finger like this. Yeah. So, if it is the direction of a magnetic field lines means, and this is the direction of a, this is the direction of a current means, what is this? What is this, guys? This is force. Where it is showing? Upwards. Where it is showing here? Upwards. So the direction of force is how here? This is the direction of a force. Understood? This is how you can use this Fleming's left hand rule while doing the experiments. Okay? If it is the direction of a current, you already know that one, the magnetic field lines goes from north to south, outside the rod, outside the magnet, outside the magnetic bar. Inside the magnetic field, what happens? The magnetic field lines goes from south to north. Okay. So here already mentioned, this is the north and this is the south pole. So obviously they are going like this. The magnetic field lines are going like this. This is the magnetic field direction, no? Like this. And this is the force. And this is a current. So this is the current direction. This is how you can show. And this is about the Fleming's left hand rule. Now, we understood, guys, this one. Any doubts here? I think no doubts. Okay. Yeah. Now, next question will be, so this force is depends on what here? This force is depends on what here? What kind of force is comes when you are using a current and magnetic field lines? I mean, when the magnetic field lines occurs in any conductor, what kind of force you feel that? And I mean, force is depends on what here? The if I say in simple words, force is depends on what? Force is depends on what here? Okay, so let us see that one. So here, I will just write one more. F is directly proportional to B, I and B, I and L. F is directly proportional to B, I and L. So, F means what here? This is a force. F is force. B is denotes magnetic field. B means what here? B denotes a magnetic field. Got it? So B is here magnetic field. Obviously, I you all know that is current. So L is what here? Length of the wire. L is what here? The length of the wire. So here force is, what is this? Length of the conductor. Yeah, length of the conductor. Yeah. Yeah. So next is what here? This force is depends on BIL. How to remember this one? You get some questions, children, in the exam. You might get objective questions like a force depends on magnetic field, current, and conductor. Length of the conductor. You have to keep it in mind. So how you will remember this one? Think that how you will remember this one? I am going to give the name of Bill. What you will need to remember? How you to need to remember this one? Bill. Okay, B I L. Force is directly proportional to B I L. Force is depends on the B I L. B means magnetic field. How much? If it is more magnetic field, more force. More magnetic field, more force. Okay, I. If more current, then again more force. Clear? And L is length of the conductor. If it is conductor length is more, the wire length is more, then you will get the more magnetic field, then you will get the more current, then you will feel the more force in this. Understood my point here? Understood my point here, children? Fleming's left hand thumb rule. Okay, so what we learned here, Fleming's left hand thumb rule, this is how it shows. Okay, this is the direction of a force, this is the direction of a magnetic field, and this is the direction of a current. How to remember this one? Father, mother, and child. Father, F. Okay, force. Mother, M. Magnetic field. Child, current. Child, C. Current. Okay, this is how it happens with the experiments. In the experiments. Clear. So this force is depends on what? This force is depends on what here? That force is depends on magnetic field, current, and length of the conductor. Magnetic field denotes B, current denotes I, length of the conductor denotes L. So F, force denotes F. So force is directly proportional to B I L. So that you can write it in like you have to keep it in your mind like a bill. Bill. Okay. They might give you some options like a force is depends on a options will be magnetic field line, magnetic field, current, and length of the conductor. All above the above, they might use some like this. Just to keep it in mind, this one. Bill. B-I-L. This is magnetic field. This is current. And this is length of a conductor. Understood, guys? Length of the conductor. Okay, so here magnetic force on a current carrying conductor increases with the increase in a current. Then force on a current carrying conductor proportional to strength of a magnetic field, and third one is length of the conductor. So factors affecting the force of the current carrying conductor is F is directly proportional to B I L. It is called Lorentz force. What it is called here? Lorentz force. Understood? This force is depends on a strength of magnetic field, length of a conductor, and a current. Have you understood this? Any doubts, guys, here? Yes? Okay. Next comes here, electric motor.